Hello friends, welcome to my channel Electrical Master. This video I am going to explain about how we can make simple ATS panel to control the main supply and a diesel generator supply. Let's go to the video. We know what is ATS and AMF. ATS means auto transfer switch, and it is also called a auto main failure switch. Actually, this ATS used to control the two sources. Whenever the source 1 is failed, it will connect the load to the source 2. Similarly, source 1 is come back and it return back the source 2 supply to the source 1. That is the ATS panel. See this picture. This source 1 is the electricity supply and source 2 is the diesel generator supply. So now we are connecting load to the source 1. Whenever the source 1 electricity is not available, it change the load to the source 2 automatically. Similarly, the source 1 supply is come back, it will change the supply to the source 1. For this purpose, we are using the ATS panel or AMF panel. Now we will see how do we make the simple ATS panel for our office or home purpose. See, this is my ATS panel front panel views. Here I used some components. I list out the components here. You can read out what are the components we are using and it is needed for the ATS panel. I am using here 3 ammeters for measuring the load current and voltmeter for measuring load voltage. This is the voltmeter selector switch for the single phase and 3 phase voltage we can measure. And this is measure the frequency of the output. And this is the emergency stop button. And this indication for ROEB supply in the load. And this for the auto or manual operation for the ATS panel. If you put the auto mode, then ATS panel will sense the source 1, this is the electricity supply. Whenever the electricity supply is not available, it automatically changes the load to the diesel generator supply. Similarly, electricity supply is come back, it will change the load to the electricity supply and switch off the DG. Let's see now we can do the wiring for the ATS panel. See, this is the ATS panel wiring diagram. First I will explain the power diagram, then we will see the control diagram how we can give to control the ATS panel. Here this is the incoming from the electricity board and this is incoming from the diesel generator. So incoming from the electricity board, which is connected to the K1 contactor. And this generator incoming supply is connected to the K2 contactor. Whenever this K1 magnetic contactor is energized, it will give the supply to directly, this is the load breaker. When the load breaker we manually close, it will connect it to the outgoing loads. Similarly, from the DG supply, it's connected to the K2 magnetic contactor. Whenever this magnetic contactor is energized, this supply is again going to the MCCB1. From the MCCB1 manually we close, it's going to the load. Now here, this magnetic conductor from the electricity and the generator, we are making the interlock. The purpose of interlock is, we want to activate these two conductor, only one conductor at a time. Either it's a DG conductor or either it's the main conductor. For the purpose, we are making the electrical and the mechanical interlocks. Mechanical interlock, we know, just there is some mechanical component is there that we can connect that component, we can make the mechanical interlock. But the electrical interlock we can make through the control circuit only. Now we will see how we are making that electrical interlocks. And moreover, you can see here from the main incoming supply, I am connecting here 600 volt phase failure relay. We know see phase failure relay how it is working. Phase failure relay, we need to give three phases supply ROEB. Whenever the ROEB supply is available, and this the phase failure relay will connect the common to the NO. Here you can see 15, 16 and 18. 15 is the common supply of the phase failure relay and 18 is the NO of the phase failure relay. Whenever the supply is available, 15 and terminal 18 will be closed. Terminal 18 will be closed. And here I'm using the control MCB from the single phase MCB. When we turn on this control MCB, it will connect it to the common supply of phase failure relay. From that, further extended to the timer NVO contact, and it is connected to the relay R01. Whenever the main supply is available, that common supply 15, whatever we are giving, it will return back to the 18. That 18 terminal, it connected to the timer 1. So timer will pick up, timer will activate, means after the delay sec, it will close the timer NVO contact, then NVO supply will connect to the R01. So R01 relay will be activate. The A2 conductor of timer 2 and R01 will be connected to the neutral. And this part from the phase supply and neutral, it is going to the control supply of this K1 conductor. Similarly, this side, we have taken one MCCB supply connected to the MCB5, and it is going to R02 relay. Whenever we turn on this MCB, R02 relay will pick up. Similarly, one loop is taken to the control supply of this K2 contact. From here, the load, we are connecting three CTs, CT1, CT2, CT3 for three ammeters. All CT, S1 contact connected to the ammeter, and S2 contact commonly it connected to the ground. Similarly, after the MCCB turn on, we are taking that ROEB supply with the neutral, and each ROEB phases will connect it with a single pole 6 ampere MCB, which is going to connect the indication of the output ROEB supply phase failures. Whenever the supply is available, indication lamp will show the phases. And from the same ROEB, we are taken and with the neutral connected to the voltage selector switch. From the output of the voltage selector switch, V1 and V2 terminal going to connect voltmeter A and C terminals. Similarly, one phase input phase is connected, one neutral is connected to the frequency meter to measure the frequency. So this is the front panel. I already showed this frequency meter and voltmeter and ammeter and indication lamp connections. Okay, now we will see how we can make the control supply to activate K1 and K2. And here you can see this another MCB and phase on neutral. This is for the option. Suppose you want to charge the generator battery, you can take one supply from load. Whenever the generator off, that time it will connect to the battery of the diesel generator. Throw some converter here, battery can here the voltage converter will be there. From the phase AC supply, it will connect to the rectifier, and it will change to 24 volt or 12 volt DC, and further it is taken to the generator battery. This is option one. Okay, now we will see how we can activate K1 and K2. This is the K1 activating circuit, main conductor control, and this is the diesel generator activating circuits. This is from MCB4, I told whenever the main supply available, the MCB4 we are closing. This MCB4 supply further we are taken to connected here. It's going to R01 NO. R01 where we are using here. When the phase is ready, this R01 relay will be activated through this timer. So R01 relay will activate, this NMO will be closed. Further, it is connected to the NC contact of auxiliary 2. Auxiliary 2 is the conductor 2, contactor to NC contact we are connected here. This is the electrical interlock. So auxiliary 2 is off, then only the supply further pass to the emergency stop push button. From the emergency stop, it's going to the manual auto selector switch. When we select the manual, it is going to manual stop push button, and it is connected to the close push button. When we close manually, then the contactor K1 will pick up, and K1 contactor auxiliary 1 will connected here for the holding contact of K1. So K1 will be activated, means this K1 will be closed, supply will be extended to the MCCB1. This is the manually closing. For auto means select the auto, the supply will going to the timer 2. Timer 2, we are setting 2 second or 3 second timer. At the time, after that delay second, timer T2 NO will be closed, then supply will be extended to the K1. So K1 will pick up. Similarly, K1 supply will close, it's going to the MCCB1 to the load. And this is for the indication. Whenever the load on a main supply, and it will be indicating the load on main DGs. Similarly, DG connectors from the MCCB5. The MCCB5 is closed, then supply R02 will be energized, then R02NO first will close, and it is connected to the auxiliary 1 NC contact, that is the interlock for the contactor K1. So contactor K1 is filed only, we can close the diesel generator contactor K2. So from the NC of K1, it's connected to the emergency stop push button, similarly selected to the manual auto selector switch. Manual we are selecting means same position, stop push button and start push button and K2. When we press the start button, K2 will activate and K2 contact will close, supply connected to the holding contact of K2. Similarly, auto we select, it is going to the timer 3, after the delay second, T3 will close and supply will extend to the K2. Whenever K2 is pick up, load on DG will be indicated. This is the control circuit for the K1 and K2, how we are activating. Now, this I'm told there are three timers are used. This timer one used for the diesel generator off delay. For example, suppose main supply is failure. That means this phase failure will be off. So what will happen? Phase failure off means timer one will be off and timer this NO will be open. So R01 will be NC contact. That time that NC contact will be taken out to connect the remote start of the DG. We want to start the DG in remotely. We know this is the DMC controller for the generator controlling purpose. From this controller, we are taking 12 volt supply from the terminal 8. It is connected to the NC contact of R01 relay. When the main supply is not available, this R01 will be NC. So 12 volt we are connecting here. The same 12 volt we have taken out. It is connected to the remote start signal of the DMC controller. So whenever this 12 volt present in this terminal D, the generator will activate in the auto mode and it start the generator in auto mode purpose and it give the load to the DG1 incoming set. So generator supply is available, then the same control circuit will activate, R02 activate and R02 further the process will start and it will close the contactor K2. Like this way, its generator ATS panel is working. Whenever the main supply is resumed, this MCBs are closed and phase failure relay will sense the voltages and it will close the common supply 15 to 18 terminal. So timer will activate. After the delay second of 3 or 4 second, this timer NO will be closed. Then it will activate the R01. Why we are making this timer 1? For suppose the generator is already running, main supply is come back. We want to give some delay time to stop the generator. That's the purpose we are giving a timer 2 here. So after 2 second or 3 second, R01 pick up. R01 is a NO means this NC contactor will open. So no more 12 volt supply to this ATS panel, diesel generator controller. So generator sends, there is stop in the remote start signal. So generator will switch it off. So in this way, this ATS panel is working. I hope now you will understand how the ATS panel is working. If you have any doubt, you can write it in the comment box. And if you really like this video, please give a thumbs up and share this video to your friends. Thank you so much.